Hi, this is Rich. How you doing? I'm going to do a reaction video on a psychic's channel. All right. This channel belongs to Agvila Sava, and she is psychic. All right. So she's made a ton of videos. Her and I have worked together. We've worked with a lot of clients. And before I do a video reaction, I'm just going to talk about the various things that she's uploaded and what she knows, what she does, what she talks about. But let me tell you the kind of psychic she is, okay? She's the kind of psychic girl that ever since she was a little kid, she's seeing ghosts and entities and weird, crazy, creepy shit. And, it was hard for her to relate to the family to relate to her because she could see so much. But a lot of kids have this problem, right, when they're psychic. So anyway, she could do that, and she could get out of body naturally and easily. Then over the years, she kind of, she shut down or backed off of the getting out of body thing. And she's also incredibly empathic. Like she could be walking by a person, walking on the sidewalk, and she could first start feeling their stuff and then start seeing their stuff. Their case, their how messed up they are and stuff. But when her and I met, I started helping her kind of come out of her shell, so to speak, and start feeling good again about her abilities. And she had someone she could relate to. I was relatable. I understood the entity phenomena. I understood what she was seeing and how it works and what it was and her out-of-body experience thing. I helped her nurture that and kind of pull off the limits and the whatever she had going there so she felt comfortable about getting out of body and understanding more about what it was. So I worked with her on that, and then she just started waking up more and more, and her abilities just took off, okay? And she can be walking down from one room to another, and she can shift. She can see these other planes and densities and realities, and she can step right into them. She's the kind of girl that can wake up in the morning, get up out of bed, and live for 2 weeks, and then realize, oopsie, wrong reality. And then she will wake back up in the reality that she went to sleep in. And it's the same reality, or it's a slightly different. It's like she lived 2 weeks into the future, then popped back and relived it again, normal. And it's like she's having this deja vu. Did we already have this conversation? I already did this. That already happened. What's going on? So she's learned to deal with that. And when she talks to a client, like this one down here, there's a lady. She's got a blindfold on so she can see her image here all right. And Agvila's giving her a session. When she works with a client, what happens is she will... start seeing the client's stuff. She can tune into them, see the entities in their space. Now, I've asked her about this, and it's like I say, do you actually see them floating around behind them, like standing over them and stuff, and in her room and stuff? And she says, well, yeah, sometimes, but it's also, I just see them, and I see the entity stuff around them. And I go, oh, okay. But I've asked her a lot of questions about her abilities, and she sees when she looks into somebody's past life or between lives area, it's like 3D holographic virtual reality real. It's like an out-of-body experience. It's a wide awake. She's seeing that and not the physical world. She's tuned out of the physical world, and now she's seeing what the client is seeing. She can see through the client's eyes, or she can have that perspective outside and watch what's going on. Oh man, and she can run it through all the way to the end of the incident, or she can go back before the incident started. She doesn't see one incident at a time. She sees a person's past life. She sees their like past life track. And it's kind of like a film reel, that you get the celluloid and it's just all this film going out like this, all around like this. And so you got these still frames, and you look at one still frame. She sees it like that, and she'll go, that one, because this is what the client's focused on. She'll go, okay, this one, this one. And then she'll pull it up. You've seen this sort of stuff in videos where they have advanced technology, holographic computer technology stuff. This one, explode, blow it up, make it big, zoom in. But her still frames that she's seeing is an entire freaking lifetime, the individual's lifetime. And she can relive a person's lifetime, like in. I mean, it's un-fucking-believable. It's unfathomable. It's hard to wrap your head around. But it's also a lot like reality. The nature of our reality, our multiverse, that's hard to wrap your head around. What is that? How does that work? Because we can be in more than one reality at the same time. We live in simultaneous realities in different realms. And it's like it's kind of like overself and underself, and you got a lot of underselves, but it's not really overself, underself, but it's a way to explain it. But we have attention, focus, consciousness, and awareness in one reality here, another one over here, another one here, another one here. And they can be like parallel universes, they can be exact copy universes, or they can be very different. This is like on a planet Earth, two or three perspectives or points of view and bodies on planet Earth, living on the planet simultaneously within the same life. Like this person could feasibly walk and meet their other self in another body, and they may or may not recognize each other. It's just incomprehensible how deep and wild and crazy reality is. And the same with what's going on planet Earth right now. It's really hard to wrap your head around it on so many levels. There's so many things going on with the wars and the lies and the propaganda and everything we're seeing and hearing. False deception, manipulation, mind control, all of this stuff. It's really hard to wrap your head around who's controlling what and how. Well, this is just one more thing, Ogvila. And what she does. So here's my quick, that was the introduction. Hope you liked it. A quick review, reaction to her stuff. Ready? Okay, it goes like this. All right, so we got how to deal with an NPC. Ogvila just recently had some experience with some non-playable characters in life. Did you know that? You probably knew it if you're watching our stuff. But there are people walking around that nobody's home. It's like in a computer game. A lot of people logged in, they're online and they're playing, but there are some that there aren't real. There's nobody controlling that player. It's all AI, and you can't play that character. It's a non-playable character or an NPC. Well, they've got those in the real world, in this physical world. Nobody's home. It's an AI. It's some programming. It's so biological, weird, technological, creepy, weird shit. And so she dealt with them in a certain way recently. And it, see, because these things will show up in your life and mess with you. They'll interfere with your life, trigger your shit, and stuff like this. And sometimes if you have a bad day, you can have a lot of NPCs coming at you. They're not. It's like, where is this shit coming from? This grouchy person, this bitch, this asshole over here, the guy riding your ass and you're driving your car to the bank or some damn thing, and the bank is closed or the teller machine's fucked up. And what the fuck, mate? All this NPC shit is going down. And so she dealt with them a certain way. So she made a little video on how to deal with NPCs. Okay. next video over, soul contracts, how it works, how we get and find soul contract agreements. She's explaining how we do that. We have a course over at richwest.net that explains it all, breaks it down. But you can actually learn how to do soul contract revocation watching her videos. She's got this one, and you can also, on her channel, search soul contracts, and she's got a few demonstration sessions where she demonstrates live doing it. And, I forgot to put up the, here, this is her channel. It starts here. That's that video. And you can watch, if you're really interested in what soul contracts are and how they affect your life and how to find the agreements and then how to revoke them, yeah, you can watch her videos. I've got some over on my channel too, but the next one over, she's doing a live contract removal. I think she's doing a live stream on this one. And when she does that, she can help a person. They can pull up their own soul contract agreements, but she can also see some key ones as well. And did you know that you can revoke, spot and revoke somebody else's agreements? Yeah. You can also spot your agreements with that other individual and defuse a relationship issue by dealing with your own agreements that you've made on a soul level. Soul contract being a contractual agreement or a binding agreement that you made in a soul level before you incarnated. Okay? Anyway. All right. Next one. What do we got else? What else we got here? This one right here. Soul contract agreements with our handlers. Yeah, we're being messed with. There's a heavy level of domination and control and manipulation and mind control and social engineering going on the planet daily. You can see it on social platforms. You can see it in the news, on the radio and newspapers, programming and television and music industry. We're being handled and messed with, and some people, targeted individuals, targeted by these handlers, or the handlers have handlers. So there's the phenomena of you having made agreements with the handlers before you got here. So if you focus in on that, you can start pulling those out and then revoke those agreements so that you are no longer bound to be the effect of these handlers. Now, this whole thing about issues that you have and addressing it with soul contracts, for example, our issues are multifaceted and complicated, hard to figure out, and very complex, lots of parts. So just doing one soul contract session on banking issues may not fix it, or money or finance. Those are three different issues that you might have, and those are three different subjects, and you might have three or four issues with the bank. You have three or four issues with making money, three or four issues with finances. So there's a lot to spiritual work, inner work, shadow work, the kind of work you do on yourself to improve the quality of your life while you're here. And then when you leave here, everything you're learning and knowing, finding out and experiencing and believing here, you will take with you. Now, a lot of your beliefs will fall away. When you leave your physical body, now you can float and fly and walk through a wall or teleport yourself. You'll have a lot of beliefs just fall away. Limiting beliefs about who and what you really are. So you will take all of this with you, but you will evolve or come out of your cocoon, so to speak, and see the world or the reality in a completely new, different light when you do leave here. But everything you're learning about the phenomena of life and life after death and beings and consciousness and between lives areas, soul traps, handlers, archons, entities, demons, archangels, angels, the angelic hierarchy, spaceships, spacecraft, aliens, ETs, greys, mantis, reptilians, whatever they happen to be, the good guys and the bad guys, all this stuff in the multidimensionality of reality. All that stuff you're going to take with you when you leave here. And you can use it. From this perspective, the beingness that you're being or the being that I'm being here, this is the me. This is Rich. Hi, how you doing? This me is an identity that I've assumed while being here, kind of getting caught up in the physical experience. When I leave here, I can look in the mirror. Very likely, I will look like this, except probably a younger version. I've been out many times, out of body many times, and I've looked at myself in mirrors and reflective surfaces, and I look like, usually look like a younger version of myself. Sometimes I've got that energy, glowy whitish blue glowy energy looking body. Sometimes I will have a really messed up, I go, ooh, I'm in a dark place kind of thing. So this tells us that you and I can shapeshift by virtue of what we're thinking about, focusing on, feeling, the state of our case. So we shapeshift and we appear to ourselves a certain way and we appear to others a certain way, depending on these things. So, So you can take all this with you. Okay, what's this got to do with Akvila's channel and living with a psychic and doing a video reaction video on her channel? What the hell? Earth being toxic to the first timers. Yeah, now I didn't watch this video of hers, but yeah, if you want to learn more about why Earth is toxic to first timers, check this out. Now we've discussed this. Akvila and I have discussed, I don't know about all of these, but quite a few of the videos that she makes for you on her channel. Her and I have kicked these subjects around. We've talked about them. We've experienced them together, things like that. So Earth being toxic to the first timers. You have to ask yourself, what kind of first timers are there? There's human beings that have never been on Earth, but they've been human beings on other planets, like the planet Immer, one of the Tibetan planets in the Pleiades, one of the other planets, you know, Arcturian planets or Lyran planets somewhere. You can be human, but first time on Earth is going to be a woe. It's toxic for regular human beings, good-natured, loving, kind, decent. And you lived in civilizations, you lived in on planets of loving, peaceful, like-minded individuals. And then you, let's say for some reason you drop dead there and you go in the higher realms or planes or astral planes or whatever you want to call it, not in a physical body. But now you decide for one reason or another to incarnate on physical planet Earth. It was a physical planet in some other star system, but now it's a physical planet on Earth. Toxic, more toxic here than other places. There are many reasons for that. One of the reasons is that there's an energy field around Earth that has limited our psychic abilities, limited our natural, innate ability to perceive beyond what the physical body can see. Hear beyond that. Smell, sense, touch, taste. All these perceptions. Clairsentience, that's clear knowing. You just tap into a knowing space. These are natural abilities of the being when we are not in a physical body and we get away from the reincarnational cycle over and over again. It's like, you know, you get an alcoholic addicted to alcohol and addicted to his favorite bar or his hangout. He can walk out of there, metaphor, he can leave the physical experience and be between lives, be between party hardy bars and places where he can drink and take his drugs and alcohol and all that stuff. He can be out of those places for a little while, but he's not disconnected. He's just sobering up a little and then going back. So he's not really waking up to the full value or potential of his experience going other places than the fucking bar where his alcoholic buddies are. There's other places and things to do to enjoy the life experience, right? But he just gets out for a little while and then goes back, gets out for a little while and goes back. He hasn't had time to fully awaken back up to what he really is and where he's been in his distant past or in the higher planes or densities. So we're not talking about a guy like that. That person is caught up in the toxicity of the earth experience so much that the toxicity of an abusive relationship. Person gets out of a relationship, abusive. Have you seen the pattern? You know about this pattern? They oftentimes will go back into another abusive relationship. Crazy shit. Crazy stuff. So, likewise, earth being toxic to the first timers. So a first timer has never been on earth before. So they get into a mess like this and they go, what the hell? And you may be a first timer here on earth. And Ogviel can tell that. When you do these deep scans with us, we do them together, call a dual deep scan. And then Ogviel will do a scan and work with a person individually as well. But she can see if you're a first timer, or you've been here 100 times or, you know, a lot or whatever. She can see this sort of stuff. I mean, she doesn't get a concept of it or an idea of it or a knowing. She sees it vividly 3D like this. It's like un-freaking believable. All right. With that said, I love all this is one of the reasons I wanted to do a reaction to her channel, because she's got so much great shit here. It's all over the place. And it's really in-depth, amazing, fun, neat stuff. So I wanted to, you know, if you didn't know about her channel, I went, hey, check some of her shit out. So here we go. Earth being toxic to first-timers. Another reason it's toxic is what's going on what is going on our planet at this time. Is there a lot of dark beings doing a lot of really seriously dark stuff right now? And they're way high up into the control structure, controlling hierarchy of our world. They're in government, industry, medicine, technology, everywhere. And they're very powerful. They're beyond rich. They're very rich. And they're very organized. The good news is they fight. They're in groups or families or, yeah, you can call them a cabal or a group. This group here and this, they make alliances and they work together in these massively controlling groups. And but then they fight, they bicker with each other on an individual level and on a group level. But they have their controllers above them. So all of that is against humanity. The spiritual evolution of humanity, the consciousness that we are, and they're also against individual human beings and societies, nations, countries, villages, cities, flourishing and prospering. They do not want that for us. They want to be in control. They want to know all, and they want us to know nothing, and manipulate us for our louche, for our energy, for our resources, for our physical bodies, for our brain power, for our intelligence, our intellectual abilities, for our imaginative, creative abilities and spirit. So they want us for lots of reasons. We're product. We're resource. We're the the animals on the farm. They think they own us and they use us in that way. So if you're a first timer here on earth being born, even if you've been a human a lot of times, you come here and you go, what the fuck? Whoa. And it can be very, very toxic for you. But thanks for coming to help. Just saying. All right. So next one over here. Can a human sell a soul? Last week, Aguila was talking. She said she was going to make a video about this. But we never really had a discussion about it. But I walked away going, yeah, what humans need to know. It's a long discussion, right? She's got 17 minutes and 43 seconds. I'd probably talk for 2 fucking hours. But I go, man, the thing that a human needs to understand is they have to clear for themselves the meaning of being human and a soul. The consciousness that you are is the being that you're being. Consciousness decides to be and now is being. But they're not being a soul and they're not being a human. It's consciousness and it's being. And being, what are they being? Aware and conscious. But from this perspective, because it's all incredibly unfathomable levels of creativity and intelligence, divine intelligence. That's you. It's consciousness. But not as an individual yet. But you are being aware, being conscious. Now you're going to be separate, or you're going to be individual. So now you're still not in a body yet, but you're being an awareness with an experience. So some people might label that awareness from a perspective or a point of view with some history, with some time, with some experience gone by, their personal awareness of self. Some people might say, well, that's a soul. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I mean by soul. If that's what you mean, great. We got a definition of soul. Some people may want to argue with you on that. So you want to be clear when you're talking to somebody or arguing with somebody or debating with somebody. What the hell do you mean when you say soul, right? So can you sell a soul? It's important to know the definition of what a soul is, because can you sell one or not, right? All right. Now, to be human, can a human sell a soul? Let's go with the definition I gave. It's a consciousness being aware, being conscious, and then choosing to identify itself from a particular specific point of view. And then from this point of view, it can move in and out of different universes and the multiverse, dimensions and planes, but it's got its time track of memory from this perspective of being in a time stream. It's got some memories and stuff, so it identifies with the experience and its relationships with other beings. It identifies with its emotional experiences. I'm that guy. I'm a grumpy guy. I'm a happy guy. I'm a loving being. I'm a get it done kind of being. I'm just watching. I'm neutral. You know, being. But you identify with this beingness, so we can call that. That would be the soul. And the soul, that soul can then incarnate into a human body. But that's not a human. That's a being, awareness, being. Being what? Being a soul. A soul doing what? A soul can or choose to incarnate into a human body or choose not to. It chooses to incarnate. It identifies, if it identifies itself and say, yeah, I'm a soul. I don't really use that term. I'm a being. I'm being. But if you're going to go with soul, and can you, because you, if you're going to ask the question, can you sell a soul? Do I have a soul? Am I the soul? If you go on that route, okay, that's a soul. Now, human. You're a soul in a human body. But now if you're identifying with being a human and not the soul, you're looking at the idea of an ego, the ego self, the idea of who and what you really are. And if you're thinking that I am this human, so I have this human form and this personality and this character and these emotions and these wants, desires, needs, aspirations, inspiration, optimism, and despairs and anxieties, all that stuff. This is me. Hi. Egos. You can call it ego. But you can also call, the ego, the self that you believe yourself to be as the idea, is now that the awareness has identified with, is now, as the ego, identifying with being the physical body, the human being, being human, which can also incorporates or includes the physical body, the physical human. You can leave your physical body and still identify as human. And you can still encounter reptilians, grays, giant spiders, all kinds of stuff out there. But you're going, ooh, I'm human. So it's a human consciousness is being human. So if we're going with definitions, you got to understand, you don't have to, but this is how I'd come at it. You would look at, okay, what do I mean when I say I'm human? Or if I'm talking about somebody else, a human, and can that human sell a soul? What is that human? My definition would be that's a being identifying with being a human or a life form or an experience of life with a physical appearance, whether it's physical or non-physical. It's the shape and the look and the feel and the interactions. You've been dealing with other beings just like yourself, and you call yourselves humans, and so now you're in a human non-physical place. It's still human, but it's not physically human, right? So it's human consciousness. So anyway, when we get back in, can a human, this would be this consciousness identifying in this way, in a physical body, can it sell the soul? That would mean if it thought it could, if the human being thought, I'm making a video here, right, on the same topic as Aguilas, excuse me. But if a human, thinking they are a human being, this is me, and if they think that they can sell their soul, then they are identifying with being the human, and they are not the soul. So you would have to ask them, well, what is a soul if you are the human? Right? So if you walked a person through this and helped them understand an answer to the question, can a human sell a soul? Where I would be going is to help the human who's asking the question understand that they are the consciousness that is being, the conscious awareness that is being and identifying as a being, whether they have a human body or not. And then this being moves into a body and then starts identifying as being the human. And now, can it sell the soul? No, it is, in that regard, it is the soul. The human, the spiritual being, the soul, goes into the body, identifies with being the body. Now, can it sell itself? Well, now there's a thing. So what can happen is the being that is calling itself a soul can get in this thing where they're going to sell their soul to the devil or some damn thing. What has happened is that the being, even before they got here, that being has identified with being the human being body, personality, character, ego, with the exclusion of being the soul, or having a vague idea of what the soul is. And they can make the deal with the devil or Satan or Lucifer or anybody else and sell their soul. And what that means is when the human, the being identifying as a human physical person with an ego and all this stuff, when that person dies, when their physical body dies, the only thing left is the spiritual being who has perhaps labeled itself as a soul. So it was, he was being human. He sold the soul. He was selling himself. The physical body dies. The soul is standing there going, uh-oh, what did I do? And you put yourself in bondage through an agreement, a deal. And so it's you going off to wherever if you've sold yourself, or if you were the human that sold yourself, your soul, to the devil. So that would be the answer to that question. And so if you look at somebody else and you ask yourself the question, can that human sell their soul? It all depends on what their understanding of it is. And then there's sell their own soul or sell somebody else's soul. So, which is a whole nother deep subject. Wow. Okay. I don't know about you. I'm loving my fucking reaction video on Ogvila's channel. Thank you, Ogvila, by the way. I stalked her a few minutes ago. And she's out walking the dogs. Okay. Let's see what else we got here. What else is going on around here? Come on. Oh, here's the thing. Get your free weekly psychic reading. So she's offering like some people. I forget how the offer goes exactly. You'd have to watch that video. But somebody that's watching her video, I think, is going to get a free psychic reading from her. So yeah, you might want to check out that video. See how that works. I don't know. Wow, then we got the benefits of being asleep spiritually. Oh my God. What else we got here? Let me see here. Wait, I'm confused. How to avoid soul traps. Yeah, yeah. Ooh, that's a good one. The short story on that, well, I'm not going to tell you. You have to watch the video. It's only 10 minutes long. How to avoid soul traps. The guided ubi, this one right here, the second one over, a guided ubi is like Ogvila is guiding the client there, and the client's got her eyes like this. So she has really good visuals. And a person that has really good visuals, what it means is they can really confront well their creations. And you and I are confronting this world here, and we confront the non-physical, and we confront our imagination, and we have, and our vivid, you know, images and mental imagery and memories. Do we have really vivid memory, or is it kind of a and gone, or is it thin and see-through? How good is one's memory? Some people have holographic, photographic, real memory, eidetic memory. And wow, and that's just memory. Well, if you have a memory that good, it doesn't even have to be that half that good. But if you have good visuals and a good imagination, this means you have that ability about you, your ability to confront and handle this non-physical stuff. And it also means you're able to let go of the physical world to some degree, because you're splitting your attention. Some of it goes on your imaginary realm, and some of it stays with the body, but you can get fully involved in your imaginary world if you're a good visualizer. Well, using techniques that Ogvila is probably going to demonstrate right here on this video, the client can shift more and more of their consciousness into the experience. And so you can, it's called a guided ubi, because the client's being guided by Ogvila. And it can be an out-of-body experience, depending on what you're doing and specifically how you're working it. The person may or may not go, whoa, and experience the out-of-body experience phenomena. There's a whole lot to it. I talk about it on my channel too, but yeah. So that's a good one. Don't miss that one. Damn. All right. What else we got here? Let's see here. We got to have something else going here. And then I'm going to wrap it up. I'm just going to give you an idea of what we've got here. So as you can see, Ogville and I do stuff together sometimes. Wow, this looks like a good one. Interdimensional War, Incarnation on Earth. Trying to help people that are spiritually asleep. That one drives me crazy. It's like, how do you do that? What are we doing? Really? Like, what's going on right now? Today is the first day of no masks required in the malls or the stores or anything in the country that we're in right now. It's not the USA. But there's still people running around with their masks, wearing their fucking masks and stuff. Whatever, man. How do you help people that are spiritually asleep? Or do you let them sleep? What do we do? There's something about the Ashtar command. This concept of quality versus quantity. Now that's me. We're talking about me here. It's like when I make a video, like a reaction video on Ogvila's channel, there's quality. I can do a real quality production here. I can take this and I can edit it and I can tighten it up. I could have wrote a script or at least key points, the things I want to touch and the emphasis I want to make, you know, quality. Or do I want to say, fuck it, turn on the fucking camera, start talking and pump them out. Quality versus quantity. So right now I'm going for quantity. What time is it? And look at my features. How much time, you know, do I have 20, 30, 40, 50 years left? I don't know, man. I'm just saying. Just get it out there, man. Get the message said the best you can. So, yeah, quality versus quantity. She's going to talk about that. And she has been putting out at least one video a day so far this year. And that looks like a good one. Ukraine versus Russia, programmed humanity. I am all over that right now. A lot of things I want to share about what I know about what's going on, I don't think would be approved of on this platform. So fuck it. Maybe you can go over Odyssey or some other place and find out about it. All right. The last one we're going to do here is creating your pocket world. This is what Ogvila calls when you got good imagination, you good visuals, and you can create a realm. Just imagine it into existence. And you can do lots of things with it. One of the things you can do with it is invite the entities that might be in your space bothering you in some way, and you can create a pocket world for them so that they can live there and they will be happy leaving you alone because they got even a better place. And you recognized and acknowledged the entity in your space and you found perhaps that it had some needs and wants, and so you were able to fulfill or provide those needs and wants by creating a pocket world for them. This is about creating your pocket world. Okay? Wow. You have to check. It's only 6.5 minutes long. Check it out. See what Ogvila has to say about that. All right. So this is Ogvila's channel. And I remember long ago when I talked her into starting a YouTube channel. So I feel honored that she just took off, man. She just took the fuck off. And, man, she's like outdoing me in the video department these days, man. So she's just tons and tons of great videos here. So I wanted to do a reaction video for you, mainly to kind of express my admiration and appreciation for what Vila's doing on her channel, but also to introduce some of you that maybe don't know about it or don't know how in-depth or what she really does with her channel or the kind of person she really is. So I wanted to introduce all that to you with my reaction here on her channel. So thank you for watching. We really appreciate it. And I appreciate it, Akvila. I hope she appreciates this reaction video. She doesn't know I'm doing it. And well, we'll just go from there, won't we? All right? All righty then. Thank you for watching. All right? Okay. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.